G'day guys, welcome back to the Funkyard. It's been a while. I've been a bit busy with my creative and community pursuits. I'm also trying to sell this house, as some of you may know. But I thought I'd make a video today. I'm going to introduce you to one of the greatest Australian rock albums of all time. And also, I'm going to show you a beer that I'm drinking. I may have shown this one before, actually, but you know. Beggars can't be choosers. It's a good one. It's a good one. Today I saw a post. I think I friended this person after the request because they knew somebody that I knew. I don't really know this person, but I was just scrolling over my morning coffee this morning and I saw a post and it told a story and it asked for an opinion. You know, what's your opinion on this? And it was to do with three women friends who decided to get some photos done of themselves for their partners, their husbands, for a particular occasion. I don't know if it was an anniversary or a birthday or what, but anyway, they decided to do this together and they got these photos done and, you know, they were probably a bit sexy, but you know, I've got nothing against, you know, people sending photos to their lovers, their partners, their husbands, whatever, their choice, you know. If somebody's, especially if somebody's, you know, celebrating and embracing their sexuality, you know, I think that's really healthy. But anyway, apparently all three of these partners, husbands, whatever, they all reacted negatively to these photos and to the extent of calling their wives sluts and questioning them whether they slept with a photographer, you know, just really crazy stuff. And you know, some of the responses were obviously, you know, this is unacceptable, you know, insecurities that these men need to grow up. Fantastic, obviously I'm aligned with those views myself. But there's also other ones that were, they weren't even focusing on the abuser and the abuse. They were more focused on the victim and how they maybe shouldn't have got the photos taken. They had various views on these types of photos apparently, and geez, what else? It was more about the women feeling good about themselves than it was their husbands, you know, this gift apparently. So it was basically, you know, victim blaming. And you know, we've heard this term before. It's basically when you focus on what the victim should have done to avoid the abuse instead of talking about the abuser and what their actions and what they did. So, yeah, obviously I threw my two cents in. You know, a lot of you guys know, you know, 20 years of working around this stuff and trying to get men to raise the bar for themselves and become fully functioning human beings and be able to process difficult feelings and emotions. And, you know, I mean, that's what this is all about. These guys felt something, and rather than taking responsibility for those feelings and communicating and being vulnerable, they went on the attack. And you know, this is common. This happens a lot, usually behind closed doors. But I saw these points of view coming across, and I think that's how one of them, I got attacked, and people were, they even, one person even accused me of being abusive, you know. But I remember a woman justifying, oh, this is just my point of view, you know, and all I was doing was laying down the facts and my knowledge base around this type of behavior, you know. So yeah, this is a common thing. And I'm glad this post was actually up there so these views could be exposed. I mean, these are the sort of conversations we need to have, and I hope by, you know, putting down a few points myself, that some people might read that and take something from it, because this is something that we need to change. And you know, I'm obviously really passionate about men raising the bar and growing up. This is what this is about. You know, this is the way you're behaving is like a child, you know. So you're not in the schoolyard anymore, guys. You're in a man suit, and you can do a hell of a lot more damage nowadays. So when you feel the feelings, you know, feel them. You know, take responsibility for them. Own that shit. You know, relationships bring up all sorts of emotions, you know. But if you're just going to reject your responsibility and go on the attack, you know, you're never going to have healthy relationships. You're never going to be truly happy. You're never going to have the type of relationships that men like myself get to enjoy. So just know that, you know, if not for the women or the partners that you have in your lifetime, do it for yourself. You know, learn this stuff, you know, learn to be vulnerable, learn to communicate your feelings and stop dictating and abusing and dominating and controlling your partners. Anyway, I hope that has made some sense for some of you out there. I'm going to show you the beer I'm drinking now. Now, I'm pretty sure I have shown you guys this one, but I just had a spare one in the fridge. It's the Señorita by Deep Creek, a chilly, hazy IPA. So it's a spicy Señorita, this one. I love it. It's good. I'm just going to have a sip of it now because I'm getting a bit dry. From all this talking, the album that I'm going to show you guys is by one of my favorite bands worldwide, let alone Australian bands, UMI. You know, there's a lot being said about the first three albums. And obviously I've got all of them on vinyl. Hi-Fi Way, you know, that really blew Australia away. And they, after this, they were touring with, you know, Soundgarden came to Australia and toured with UMI, and then they took them around the world. And then was it Oasis, not my favorite band, but they toured Australia, and then they went, shit, you guys are coming with us for the rest of the tour. Fantastic band, you know, amazing album, this one. There is not a bad number in this whole album, Hi-Fi Way. So anyway, I'm going to play... Look, it's not the most rocking song on the album, but it's one of my favorites. It's called Purple Sneakers. I'm sure many of you know it. It's Tim Rogers, the way he writes. This dude pretty much wrote my soundtrack in the early 90s. You know, I still remember seeing these guys live for the first time on the Sound As Ever tour, their first album after the EPs. And you know, we were there to see Tumbleweed, but we said, we'll check out this UMI. And I saw Tim doing the big windmills with his big Gibson, and it was just this three-piece band pumping out this raw Aussie rock with such passion and meaning. And anyway, and then, you know, I started reading the lyrics, and it just got me right here. So, yeah, brilliant songwriter, brilliant band. Please enjoy Purple Sneakers. See you guys next time. Sense, sure, felt like an accident, those college days.